In this video, we pick up where we left off from the previous video. Here we will use sketch offset, sketch text, shell, fillets, and reordering of history-based features. Let's get started by selecting the top face as a new sketch plane and open the new sketch. Now I'll use the offset tool to make a loop, a half inch offset from the outside. So I'll click on the offset edge tool and then select a model edge. I get the blue arrow and I can drag this in and then just key in a half inch. Click in blank space when you've got that set up, and then you can exit the sketch. Press Ctrl 1 for an isometric view, or use the orientation cube to get your view ready to extrude. Select inside the sketch and either click or click and drag to create the extrude. Make this a half an inch tall. I can add draft to this using the curved arrow and key in 10. Now I want a small inset area, so I'll click in blank space again to clear the view, and we'll go through this process again. Click on a sketch plane, click the sketch tool, click the offset edge, click an edge to offset, drag it, key it in, 0.5, exit the sketch. Notice that I'm using my space mouse for this view orientation change. They're convenient if you have access to one. Click inside the sketch loop and drag the arrow down. I'll key in 0.375 and we'll add draft to this as well. Notice that this last feature subtracted material rather than adding it. That can be controlled using this icon, where you have the option to make a new body or for your new feature to join and add material to the original body, or to subtract material from the original body, or to only keep the material that's common between your new feature and the existing body. Next, we'd like to hollow this part out. And to do that, we can use the shell feature. So I'm going to turn this over because I know I'm going to need to select this bottom face. Click on the shell. After I click on the shell, I'm prompted to select faces to remove, and I know I want to remove this bottom face. Then I'll just drag out the distance, and I'm going to key in an eighth of an inch. That's a little small, so let's increase this to a quarter inch. I'll accept that with the Done button. Now I want to add some text to the outside of the part, and this is geometry that I don't want to shell out. So I'm just going to open a sketch on this bottom face. But notice that Shapr3D is not allowing me to select that bottom face. That's because one of these sketch planes is in the way. So if I turn that off, now I can select this bottom face. That may be something that you run into from time to time. And just be aware that the items list on the right-hand side has all of the sketch planes listed, and these can be turned on or off. So I'm going to open up a new sketch at the bottom of this face. And now I'm going to add sketch text. In here, I'll type in just the word Shapr3D. You can obviously type in something else if you want to. I can use any TrueType font that's on your machine. And I'll use this value to establish a size. So 1.8. Oh, that's too big. 1.7. Nope. 1.6. Okay. Now this will do it. One thing to be careful of with this feature is that once you get the text in and the size set, once you hit continue, you cannot change the text and the size. You'll have to delete the sketch, come back and recreate the sketch text that you want to put on there. But I can move the existing text. So I can move it back and forth. I can key in a value. I can move it up and down. I can rotate it, which is very nice. And this pad allows me to move it in X and Y. You can also move the reference if you need to move this to a specific point to make it easier to position the entire text. Once this is in place and sized properly, I'll just click done for that and then exit the sketch. Now to extrude this, I need to select the multiple regions in here. So I'll click on the first one and then shift select inside the rest of them. Be aware that some of these letters have internal loops. And so if you're selecting this in reverse, selecting the outside, you'll also need to select inside these loops. With that selection, I can now create the extrusion. So we'll say 0.1, and we have sketch text. This concludes part 3 of the cover video series. Please proceed to part 4.